Hello students, and welcome in today's session. Today we are going to see about the ecological succession. Right now in this ecological succession we will study that how the ecosystem goes on succeeding and reaching to the climax community, right? Either it will be start from the xeric condition or from the bare rock, or it may start from the aquatic system, that is from the pond or a lake, right? But finally it will reach to its climax community, that is nothing but the forest. So this is what it is called as a ecological succession. Let's see about the ecological succession in detail. This is an important characteristics of all communities, right? Here the composition and the structure of each and every community goes on changing constantly. It will never be a stable, right? And these changes are there. These changes are in response to the changes in the environmental condition. As the environmental condition changes, they will also respond to these changes in a changing in their structure and in their composition. So automatically there will be change in the communities, right? So this is continuously going on process. Now this changes are there. These changes are in orderly and sequential. Orderly and sequential means one after another, a particular sequence is there. With that sequence only we can see the changes in orderly manner. It's not like that any change takes place anytime, right? Then it also goes parallel with the changes in the physical environment. Whatever the changes will takes place in the physical environment, in response to that only the changes will occur parallelly along with that only in the community, right? Changes leads finally to a community that is in a near equilibrium with the environment, right? Now what is mean by near equilibrium? Whatever the environmental conditions are there, in that environmental condition whatever the equilibrium means the state of equal constant, right? Where something is not more or not less, and this equilibrium everywhere it will be in the common same concentration, that is what it is called as a equilibrium state, right? So these communities after sequential changes, orderly changes, parallel changes along with the physical environment reach to the equilibrium state where the environmental conditions or the physical environmental conditions are there, that and community will have the equilibrium state, common state with each other, right? And this equilibrium state is there, that is called as climax community, right? So climax community means the end community, that will be the end, means a stable community will be formed. Moreover it will be remain constant for long time, right? The gradual and fairly predictable changes in the species composition of a given area is called ecological succession. This is the definition of ecological succession. What is mean by ecological succession? Now ecology means what, that you know, right? This we are talking about the environment. Whatever the plants, animals, organisms are there along with the biotic and abiotic components in their with their interactions, right? So this will comprise this in the ecosystem, ecology, right? And succession means go on changing step by step. It will go on changing, succeeded, ahead, right? So this will be comes in the succession. So wherever the gradual means slowly and fairly predictable means whatever the surrounding environment is there, natural conditions are there, along with that natural conditions we can predict some of the changes in the ecosystem, and these changes are there, predictable changes are there, that will given with the species composition, means this type of environment is there, these types of species will occur in this ecosystem. This is what it is called as fairly predictable changes in the species composition. Whenever it will be given for a particular area, then it is called as a ecological succession. Now during this succession, some species colonize in an area and their population becomes more numerous, right? So maybe whatever the favorable conditions will be there for one or two species, then these species will go on increasing their number, they will go on colonizing, and because of that their favorable conditions are there, their number will be increase a lot, they becomes numerous, right? Their population will go on increasing, right? So in this way particular species number will be the highest according to that time's environmental condition, where the population of other species may get a decline or even disappear. Whenever the one species population will be the numerous, increase the high, then automatically this species will eradicate other species, or the number may get decreased. Possibility, both possibilities are there, right? Now see the next term, series. What is mean by series or series? The sequences of communities that successively change in a given area are called a series. Once again, see the sequence of communities. Whatever the community is present now, right? After some years, this community will get replaced by the any other community, right? And these successive changes will be there. The first, then the second, then third, then fourth. So whatever these successive changes we see about the communities, then each and every community is there, that is called as the series. These terms are again important for you when we are learning the ecological succession ahead, right? The individual traditional communities are termed as serial stages or a serial community when we are talking about a one single community, right? So that will be considered as a serial stage or serial community. Successive serial stages, there is a change in the diversity of the organism. So whenever serial stages will go on changing, then along with that whatever the species or the organisms are there, their diversity will also be go on changing with each serial stage, right? And that will increase the number of species and organisms as well as increase in the total biomass, because as the diversity is increased, number of the organisms will increase, and as the number of organisms will increase, definitely total biomass of that community will go on increasing. All these points will be clear to you whenever we will see the example of the succession, right? See, succession, hence it is a process and that start where no living organisms are there, right? So without any living organism, it will start from the zero. So there are the areas where no living organisms may be ever existed earlier, and that without living organisms, this area maybe in future becomes a climax community, maybe it converts into a forest. Now how is it converted from no living organism to the highest biodiversity with a huge biomass, right? So this we will study here in the succession. Example is given, the area where no living organism is exist, that is nothing but a bare rock. Just take a very big bare rock where on the rock no any life can survive, right? So in that bare rock, all living organisms may not be exist over there, right? So whatever here the succession will be start with the bare rock, this is called as the primary succession, right? And if the succession start with the area where already there the living organisms were there, but they have lost because of some of the reasons, right? Then when the succession start from such area, then that would be called as a secondary succession. Take two examples. One the succession is starting with the bare rock and another succession will be start. Earlier there was a forest, right? But because of some reason, the forest get fired, right? So the all forest just get burn out. And whatever the plants, animals, organisms were there, they have lost in that area. So in that area, no living organism is there. Not a single living organism. So we have here two situations. One is the bare rock where no life is there. And another one is the burned forest where no life is there, right? But earlier it was existed over there. So in that case, bare rock succession is there. That is called as a primary succession because it start from the zero, right? And the succession which occurs in the forest, burned forest, where now life is not there, but earlier it was existed over there. So that is called as the secondary succession. Question may asked that they will give you the example and they will ask you, you have to identify either it is an example of primary succession or the secondary succession. So remember that without any life, if the succession begins, then it is primary succession, and whenever the succession begins on the place where earlier the life was there, but now it was lost, and from again the new life is started on that place, then that why it, that then it will be considered as a secondary succession. Example is given for the primary and secondary succession is that, see, primary succession occurs are newly cooled lava, bare rock, or newly created pond or a reservoir where the earlier life is not there, not at all, right? So new life is going to be start from the beginning, right? So these are some of the examples where the primary succession begins, right? The establishment of a new biotic community is generally very slow in the primary succession. Why? Because new life is going to be formed and forming a serial stages at every community, so it will take a time. So it is a very long and very slow process is there, right? Now whenever it takes a naturally as a natural process, several hundred to several thousands years will take to produce a fertile soil from the bare rock. Means whenever we are talking that the bare rock will start the primary succession, then the rock is there. Now if the plant has to grow on that, then the soil is needed. So this bare rock under will go on weathering process, and due to the weathering process, slowly this rock will convert into a soil, right? So this rock is converts into a fertile soil. It will take several hundreds or several thousand years whenever this process takes place naturally. So by this you can understand that how much slow process is there of a succession, right? See on the next page, secondary succession is there. This secondary succession begins in the areas where the natural biotic communities have been destroyed. Means earlier biotic communities were there, right? And they have get destroyed because of some of reasons, maybe the natural calamities or anything, right? Examples are given in abandoned farmlands, burned or cut forest land, and have been flooded, right? Due to the flood also, this everything is over, finished. All lives are finished over there. Some soil or the sediment is present. Succession is faster than the primary succession. Now in secondary succession, as your abandoned farms are there, means everything will be cut and cleared, right? Forest, whenever it is cut and cleared or it is burned, right? Farms, lands or forests get burned, right? Whenever anyone area is flooded, so where the all life is get destroyed completely, right? But here, as we have seen the bare rock, where the rock has to convert first into the soil, and then in that soil the plants will start to grow. Means the forming soil is a very long process, thousands of years are required. But here in this secondary succession, as the flood is there or abandoned farmlands are there, or forest is there which is cut or burned, right? Here the soil will be present, life will not be there, but the soil is present, right? So whatever the time period is required in the primary succession to form a soil, that will be saved over here, right? So that's why secondary succession is the faster than the primary succession, right? So this is what the difference between the primary succession and the secondary succession. Now see here, succession precedes the number and the type of the animals, and the decomposers also change, right? In the succession, these organisms time to time they will go on changing. Now this you will understand with the example. See, next point is your succession of a plants. Now your next point is the succession of a plants, right? Now in this plant we will see how the different series occurs in the succession for developing a plants, right? Now as we have seen earlier, the succession may start from the bare rock, dry place, or maybe in the newly formed pond or lake, right? Now based on the nature of the habitat, there are two types of the successions, right? Whenever the succession of the plant is occur in a dry areas, right, means as like a bare rock, right, then it is called as a xerarch succession, right? It is called as a xerarch succession. And whenever the succession is takes place in water, right, where the habitat is water, for example wet area, pond or lake, newly formed pond or lake, then that succession is called as the hydrarch succession, right? Now see here the word water, hydra, right? Hydra is related with the water. Hydrarch succession means start with the water. And xerarch, xerophytic, right? The word you remember, xerophytic, xerarch means it is dry. So whenever the succession begins with the dry areas, it is called as the xerarch succession. See, hydrarch succession takes place in the wetter areas, wet areas where the water is available, right? Successional series progress from hydric to a mesic condition. Hydric means waterlogged conditions, to a mesic conditions means the land one where water and soil will be in optimum amount, right? So the hydrarch succession begins from the wetter areas or the aquatic areas and reach to the mesic condition. Now if you will see the xeric succession, it will occurs in a dry area, right? And series of progress takes place from xeric condition, means dry condition, to again the mesic condition. Now in both successions, if you will see, then the end of hydrarch succession and the end of xeric succession is the mesic conditions, right? So the both succession will reach to the mesic condition at last, right? So both hydrarch and xeric succession leads to a medium water condition, that is the mesic, neither too dry nor too wet, right? So this is what a medium condition where both will reach there. The species that invade a bare area are called the pioneer species, means the first species which will appear on a bare rock, right, or a bare area, right? So that first invading species is there, that is called as a pioneer species. Now the pioneer species for hydrarch succession it will be a different, and for xeric succession it will be a different, right? In the primary succession on a rock, the pioneer species is usually lichen. This question will be asked in exam. In the primary succession on rocks, the pioneer species means the first coming species is usually lichen. Lichens will grow on a bare rock, right? They secrete some of the acids on the rock, and due to the acids activity, rock will get dissolved, right? And because of this acid secreted by the lichen, weathering process of the rock is there, it will become faster, and small amount of soil formation will be takes place. As little bit soil is formed, Then on that small amount of soil, small plants like bryophytes will start to grow. Now these bryophytes are there, they will again grow on that, they will again increase the weathering process of the rock, again more amount of soil is produced over there, and these bryophytes then replaced with the pteridophytes, or in this way the small plants will go on replacing by the bigger plants, and this succeeding process will be takes place. After several more stages, ultimately a stable climax community of the forest community is formed, and this last final climax forest community is formed. This is what it is called as the mesic condition of the xeric succession, right? See the slide. This is what the example of succession showing, where the primary succession start on the rock, right? So on the rock surface these small bryophytic plants are grown. So here the weathering process of the rock is begin, right? And here the secondary succession means already the forest where their soil is there, and a new species is going to be formed. So earlier burned forest is there, on that a new life is forming. So this will give you the example of the secondary succession. Next slide is there where the primary succession begins, right? So this is what the lava or a bare rock, on which due to growing of the lichens then replaced by the bryophyte, then bryophyte replaced with the little bit larger plant, and in this way life start to grow on this rock, right? So this explains us how the primary succession goes on, starting with the bare rock. In the primary succession, see here this is given the sequential series, how the changes takes place and reach to the climax community. If it is looking, then you can see here this is the bare rock, right? Then on this rock lichens are grown over here, then these lichens will get replaced by the small annual plants as well as some of the larger lichens, right? So this rock slowly get withered, convert into the small particles, right? And finally becomes into the soil. Then these small annual herbs are there, lichens are there, get replaced with the grasses and perennial plant, right? Then again after some years these plants will again get replaced with the grasses, shrub, shade plants are there, or intolerant trees are there like pines are there, they will be grow over there. Again as the environmental conditions are changed, these species will get replaced due to change in the conditions of this community, and this will be again changed with the shade tolerant trees such as oak trees and large trees, big trees are there, right? So finally this rock slowly due to change in the different series, it will reach to the final series to form a forest community, right? This is what it is called as the climax community. These are called as the intermediate species of the community, and these are the pioneer species, those who are invading on the bare rock, right? So this will shows you the complete picture of a primary succession. And to carry out this whole primary succession, hundreds of years timing is required. So it is a very slow process and a lengthy process. So once upon a time where there was only rock, after hundreds of years you can see, able to see the forest on that same place, right? So this is what a primary succession start with the rock, right? As it is a dry condition, so this is known as a xeric succession, right? This figure is there which will explains you the secondary succession. Earlier the forest was there, but due to the forest the so due to the fire this forest is get lost, right? So life is over here there, right? But on that soil nothing is there, no life is there. Slowly on that same soil annual plants will grow. These annual plants then replaced with the perennial plants. These perennial plants and grass afterwards replaced with the shrubs, pines, right, trees, and finally with the forest trees, right, big trees, right? So in this way the earlier forest get lost and again a new forest has developed on this soil. So this is called as the secondary succession. So in the secondary succession also again the climax community of the forest is formed, right? So here this secondary succession, if you will see, it will occurs in a 150 years, right? Or maybe 200 years it will take, not of thousands of years. So as compared to the primary succession, secondary succession is little bit faster, right? So this is what it is given over here, same just now whatever we have seen in the slide, that how the xerophytic habitat get converted into a mesophytic one. This is all description is given. With this description you can understand this better with the figure which is given in your textbook. This is what a hydra succession, right? Here the pond is given where only water is there, and with that water some of the phytoplanktons are there. Now these phytoplanktons, it will go on increasing, and as they get die, decay, get settled down over here, and some of the fertile kind of soil will be formed over here. Then these phytoplanktons will get by submerged plants, right? Those who are underwater, right? Submerged one, right? Now these submerged plants are there. After some time these submerged plants will get replaced by the floating plants, submerged floating plants, right? Then after some years these submerged and floating plants are there, this will get replaced by the reed swamp stage. Now reed swamp stage where the water will be more along with the soil, right? Marshy conditions like structure will be there, right? Then after this condition the habitat which is occurs over here, in that habitat these plants cannot be survived. So this will get eliminated and the plants which are suitable for these conditions will grow over here, right? Like a typha plants. Now as soon as these plants will go on increasing and day by day they will get dead and their remainings will be added, in that water will decrease, soil amount will be increased, and this marshy medium stage is there, this will be get replaced by the scrub stage, right? Where the land will be formed from the pond and where the different types of plants will grow, and after some years then this scrub stage is also replaced by the forest. So this is what the climax community forest is formed. At last the forest climax community is formed, right? So in this way we have seen that how the pond is finally converted into the forest, and in the xeric condition also in earlier slide we have seen that how the bare rock is converted finally into the forest. So based on their habitat we have seen that two types of succession, one is the xeric one and this one is the hydrate succession. Finally both these types of succession will end in the mesic condition, which is their climax community of the forest, right? So based on this also one more question will be asked, that whether what is the climax community for the xeric succession or the hydrate succession, both are ending with the mesic conditions, right? So here about the hydrate and xeric succession is over. So today we have seen about the succession, right? Ecological succession, in that we have seen about the hydrate succession and the xeric succession, even the primary succession and the secondary succession. Based on the primary succession and secondary succession, one or two mark question will be asked, and based on the xeric succession and the hydrate succession, two or three marks question will be asked. So prepare all these points very nicely for the exam. If you have any doubt related to this, write in comment. If no doubt is there, like the video, complete your notes, send me the pics, and do your best. All the best.